am Nitin Gansare and I am assistant professor in Fodeshar College. I teach at BSc and MSc level. So today, what I have planned is, are you comfortable in English or should I have in Marathi English? Marathi English, sir. Ready? So when we are talking about chemistry, so there is 11 questions total from chemistry will be asked in the NTS examination out of 100. So 11 marks are there for chemistry. For chemistry, the basic fundamentals, what we are expecting out of you, that is basic from 9th and 10th standard syllabus. But what generally which starts with the school, they are the chapters which we have discussed in the classrooms. But we are going to be discussing the basics of fundamentals of chemistry over here. So when we are talking about chemistry, so I want to interact with you, first of all. Okay? So when we are thinking about chemistry, so what do you think of first about chemistry? When you think about chemistry, what strikes to your mind first? One by one, yes. Atom and molecules. Very good.
circular distance around the nucleus away
from the nucleus traveled by the electron. Now electrons, they are moving around the nucleus, yes or no? Now how they are moving? Any idea? How electrons are moving around the nucleus? Circles. You are saying dumbbell shape. Okay, and that is the answer of the question orbit and orbit. Now when we are talking about orbit, there are different types of orbits. First orbit, second orbit, third orbit, fourth orbit. They are also called as K-shell, L-shell, okay, M-shell, right? L-shell, M-shell, like that. K, L, M, N, like that. Okay. Now these are the maximum distance away from the nucleus. And if that distance, maximum distance, if it is R, and if you draw a circle with that radius, that's the maximum distance away from the nucleus, okay, traveled by an electron. Now, first shell, okay, it is called as a K shell, which is also called as the principal shell, okay. So, here in the first shell, there is only one type of orbital, which is called as S orbital. Now, what are orbitals basically? Now, atom is a three-dimensional entity. Dimensional entity means 3 x, y, and z axis. Okay, what is the fourth dimension? Time. How you describe that? Right? Suppose if I am crossing the grid road and if at all any vehicle has to come and hit me, all four dimensions should match. Okay, x axis, okay, y axis. If I am in the air, Z axis will not match. I have to be on the road, so that vehicle will hit me. That is the Z axis and time. Time axis should also match. Same time, I should be in the middle of the road. At same time, the vehicle has to come and hit me. Unless and until all these four dimensions match, the phenomena will not happen. Is this clear? All four dimensions, okay. So when we are talking about the atom, we are talking about nucleus, we are talking about the electrons revolving around the, or moving around the nucleus. Now this nucleus, as I told you, the imaginary circles with the maximum distance traveled by the nucleus, that are called as principal shells, or they are called as orbits. But in that orbits also, different electrons, they take different types of path in three-dimensional space. Whether they are moving in circular manner or in dumbbell shaped manner, they are called as orbitals. Okay. So what are these orbits and orbitals that we are talking about? Okay. So first shell comprises of only one type of orbital, which is called as S orbital, whose shape is spherical, just like a football. Imagine a football. The nucleus is exactly at the center of the football, and that synthetic material or a layer of football comprises of the orbital. So here, orbitals in to talk about the definition of orbital, orbital is nothing but the imaginary three-dimensional space around the nucleus where the probability of finding the electron is maximum. It's an imaginary three-dimensional space around the nucleus where probability of finding the electron is maximum. I just explain you with some analogy. For example, I'm here in this building, and suppose my friend, okay, he stays at near Alka Doctors. And if at all I have to meet him, I have to proceed in that direction only. If I proceed towards Parvati, there are no chances that I will meet my friend. So probability of meeting my friend zero over there. If I proceed in this direction, probability will increase. So why I am giving this analogy? Because we are using the same analogy when we are talking about the bond formation process later on. Okay? We are talking about orbitals and orbits. second type of second shape, second orbit, and now it comprises of two types of formators, S and P. S and P. The P orbitals, they are having dumbbell shape. How it is? Now there are three types of P orbitals. Three types of P orbitals. Px, Py and Z. Right? That is the shape of the orbital. It's dumbbell shape.
Plane of the
like that. Why is it? it will be like this, because this is y axis, this is z axis, so it will be having four lobes. Okay, they are lying in this y z plane. Are you getting it? Just imagine four lobes, 1, 2, 3, 4. X z along x and z, 1, 2, 3, 4 in this. Are you getting my point? So there are three lobes, three planes you can say. This is the plane containing x, y axis, plane of the blackboard. So dxz orbitals, okay, they will be having all the four lobes lying in this plane, xz, xy plane. Are you getting? Xy, two axes, they are in one plane. So this is the plane containing x and y axis. So this is z axis facing towards you. So xz plane will be the plane which is perpendicular to the plane of the blackboard. This is the plane of the, this is this plane of the table is nothing but the xz plane. So obviously the four lobes lying in this plane. How about the yz plane? Consider this plane. This is yz plane. Because it is in y axis, not z axis. Now consider the three planes. Plane of the blackboard, plane of this table, and this side of this dais. Podium, here, like this. So they are all in perpendicular to each other. Right? So, dxy, dxz, dyz, they will be having four lobes, okay, in those respective planes. Is this clear? Now, how about dx square dash y square? It is a d orbital having four lobes along x and y axis. Like this, 1, we have a colored chalk. So dx square y square, they are having all the four lobes along x and y axis. Okay. Then how about dz square? So it is along z axis, but its shape is like this. Suppose this is the z axis. It will be having two lobes and one more ring. Now these are the areas, imaginary areas, mind well. Nobody has constructed a road like that. That this road is the road for the electrons to move. No. It's an imaginary space in three dimensions. Where the probability of finding the electron is maximum. So electron is moving in this lobe, no doubt. And these are the areas, and that's why they are called as orbitals. Are you getting my point? So the third shape is having S, P and D orbitals. Fourth shape will have S, P, T and F orbitals. And the shape of the A orbital is diffuse. Diffuse means there is no clear-cut areas demarcated, just like a cloud. Okay? Just like a cloud. So area over here, so the shape of the A orbital is not certain, it is diffused. For example, the D orbital, they have got certain shape, but A orbitals, they don't have the definite shapes. Okay. Now, how many types of A orbitals are there? There are 7 types of A orbitals. S orbital is only one type. P orbitals, how many P orbitals are there? 3. D orbitals? 5. And F? Now each orbital प्रश्न। अब सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द एनर्जी ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन। वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एनर्जी ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द एनर्जी ऑफ द ऑर्बिट्स एंड ऑर्बिट्स। नाउ एज वी गो अवे फ्रॉम द न्यूक्लियस, एनर्जी ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन इंक्रीजेस। When we are talking about the energy of the electron, the total energy of any electron comprises of two types of energies. They know which two types of energies? Potential energy and kinetic. How potential energy? Because electron is negatively charged, nucleus is positively charged. So obviously there is a force of attraction, and because of that force of attraction, each electron is having certain potential energy. At the same time, electron is moving continuously around the nucleus, and that's why it is having kinetic energy. So total energy of electron comprises of potential energy as well as kinetic. Okay. Now as we go away from the nucleus, the energy of the electron increases because its kinetic energy is more. Potential energy is also more because again, see over here, potential energy inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Okay, now see over here. Okay, as we go away from the nucleus, the force of attraction is reducing, but its kinetic energy is more, and that's why the electron from the outermost orbital is detached from the nucleus, and that is the electron is called as valence electron. You all know this valence electron, which can be removed, or the valence shell in which we can add the electron. Are you getting it? So is this clear up till now? What is orbit? What are orbitals? And what are the different types of orbitals? Is this clear? Is this clear? Now, if you understood this, we'll talk about the electronic configuration. Electronic configuration will tell us how many electrons are there and how they are placed around the nucleus in an atom. Okay? And there are two important principles followed in arranging the electrons within the atom around the nucleus. What are these two principles? First one is called as the off-bound principle. Do you know that? Have you heard about this? Have you heard about this? Yeah, explain it. It doesn't matter if you go wrong. Huh?
Fifth shape
S, P, D, and F. Sixth cell, S, P, D, and F. Now, there is one more cell set, which is called as quantum numbers. Do you know this? Yes. The quantum number, quanta means packet. Now, according to this theory, quantum theory, the energy of the electron is quantized. Is it is fixed? Okay. It is quantized and it is fixed. So, according to the quantum number, there are different types of quantum numbers. Principal quantum number, quantum numbers, abbreviated N. It gives you idea about which shape is in which the electron is present. Principal quantum number, that is which shape or the orbit. Then we have got azimuthal quantum number, and it gives you idea about which orbital in which electron is present. It is called as azimuthal quantum number. I tell you.